Today, we will be doing a MPF release. So, if you're interested in that, you can follow me along if you want. This will be, a little bit more, I would say, chatting and doing some stuff together. And if you're interested in how releases are made, then this might be for you. It's not very scary. It's not very tricky. It's generally very simple, I would say. But somebody has to do it. Usually that's me. And that's why I will do like the release today. I would just start with that. And the good thing is that we have done this before, and for that reason we also have like kind of a checklist for that, so how what to do and how to do it. And yeah, we will give that a try. Might not be interesting for everybody, but maybe you want to know how this works, and I will just show you today for a little bit. It's I know it's Sunday afternoon or Sunday evening, but it's a wonderful time to do that. And yeah, let's do it. So I know that we got a checklist somewhere here, but I do not quite know where it is. Probably at versions. Yeah, so we got MPF release checklist. And the MPF release checklist is what we use to make releases. And because like we've done this before quite a few times, and every time we refine this checklist, and then we go with that. So first thing is update the MPF release notes. Okay, that's this thingy here. So since we didn't do that before, that might take us a while. So I will, we'll start with that. So if you look at previous like posts, this has looked like this. And so those are like our blog posts. You can see last post has been in May, so quite some time ago, and we did a release in November last year. And I will just copy this one to this year. And today is, what's the day? It's the 25th of June in English. And that's 7 and 25. MPF 055, and now we go for that. So 55 has been released, 55, and I like this language stuff. So release what? Yeah, I then. Yeah, we want to do like the 055 release, and like that has been due for us quite some while, especially since like Ubuntu 20.04, basically the installer doesn't work really well on this distribution. And for that reason, I want to do like the 55 release. That's made sure enough at the moment. There aren't any open points, I would say. And so let's do it, I would say. So let's see if we got any breaking changes. So what we typically do is we go through all the commits here and make like a change log out of those. So I will go back to like when we released 054. That can be quite a bit. Let's see. And usually I go over all of those and then we create like one large change log. And usually, okay, it's development of half a year, so probably a lot of stuff happened. Okay, that's a lot. So let me zoom out a little bit. 55, 20, okay. 11? Okay, what did we do? I mean, what did we do anyway? Today is the date we will find out. So, let's go over it and have a look. So here we started. That has been basically the last release in 54, other way around. And afterwards, we see what we got here. Conditional random event player. Okay, let's see what it is. So we got... Okay, that's just... Okay, that's still another one. Okay. Let's see. Prevent crash during error handling. Okay, that's bad. Okay, that's a bug fix. And I kind of stopped the blog post, to be honest, right? So I did this until the release, but I didn't do it afterwards. I don't know how many people actually read those blog posts. I don't know, to be honest. And maybe a few, but probably not too many. I mean, we don't know. Some people gave us feedback, but that hasn't been like too much. And for that reason, I guess like we will keep it a little bit simpler now. So that the installing stuff. Now I can I somehow put this side to side. Kind of like this, right? So what do we have? Breaking changes. Let's see if we have some. Ubuntu 20.04. Okay, yeah, we had that on 54. Rob, yeah, we did, but like with the old Python stuff. So let's see, new config options. Let's see if we got something on this. We probably got a lot of bug fixes. Others, let's see. Kind of that. Let's go. Bug fixes, that's just an ordinary bug fix. New features is flashing segment displays in PROC. I don't know if anybody's using that, but we added this at some point. Flash match segment display match flashing. Yeah, like we had a lot of segment display stuff, I guess. PROC pulse power. Interesting, but it has been working. New feature. Initial virtual pinball engine support. I guess like virtual pinball engine is getting better and better. And I think that will hit the road soon. So, and we're like prepared in MPF, but it's not, a lot of people are already using it. Hey, welcome back, Basiron. So today we're doing a release. I'm just starting here to do run like a release check, release notes, right? So, I will do that. So like a lot of stuff going here. I don't know if we actually like make it if I go like that, so because there are probably like a few more pages here. Let's see. You can see how what all the awesome like contributors did here. So like Anthony did like a lot of stuff, and he usually also does awesome pull requests with a lot of like documentation or explanation why stuff is done, so that's great. Is Virtual Pinball Engine the Unity thing that integrated with MPF? Yes. Yes, exactly. That's like the successor of VPX, or so the Virtual Pinball, like the Virtual Pinball thingy, which like had those old GUI and would only run on Windows, and didn't have like the greatest usability. I think Virtual Pinball Engine in Unity is like a lot cooler in this regard. So okay, cool. Wow. Didn't know. Config player. This pull request adds a new setting option to all config player based classes delay. Okay. Oh. On all of them? Interesting. So Anthony did a lot of stuff here, apparently. And I didn't know. Okay, cool. So you can have a delay setting. Okay, maybe we need some tests for that. Because we need some examples and some documentation for that, I guess. New config options. New delay setting for all config player based. Config players, like that. Config players to delay execution. So you can, for example, delay, I don't know, playing a show or something. That's cool. That's actually cool. I didn't know. I actually didn't know that this happened. This actually, that he did that. Let's see. And we have more. And we're still like in last year, so. Okay, that's maybe I should do like the changelog later. Maybe let's do a release first, and then I will do the changelog later, because that might be boring for you. I don't know. It depends on how much you want to see that. So here we got like change to add to counters, right? Which is great. So what we usually got is like we got full release notes in the documentation, which is release notes, and there we like link like everything, so that looks like this. So it's a lot of stuff here, as you can see, and that's more like we link to the commits. So actually we create this mostly out of like our changelog, and this is more like the highlights, right? And but I don't know if we need to do like all the the fancy stuff. So if we like have to be so detailed, because I mean that's like already available if you go to the Git repository, so you could to go there. You probably, most people won't. But then they also won't read our changelog. So it's similar. So what's the change? So the change is new parameters. New argument remaining in logic blocks. Encounters, that's it. Okay, but that's a great change. Let's see. Documentation test, nobody cares about that. Bug fixes, internal stuff. New config option enabled for displays. Okay, that's great. I mean, it's a small thing. But you can disable displays now, so that's I think it's a great thing. Like this. So new option enabled for displays. So that can be used to disable like displays if you got like multiple configs. So for example, you got one configuration for debugging your machine and one for like running your machine. And this way you can disable certain displays when you're running the machine and have them in your debug settings. That's the idea here. That's why Anthony built it. But I think it's great. I like it. We fixed the color correction bugs. Okay, that's a great thing. Fixed color correction bugs. That's not color correction. Fixed bugs during fading. So we had some bugs where we would like get fading wrong in some corner cases, because we would like take timestamps at the wrong point of time actually, and that's something we changed. And new features, breaking changes, removed Python 3.4 support. That's a breaking change. We did like a lot of modernization in 0.55, which also gives us some performance also, but that's kind of those changes here. Where we removed like a lot of those weird arguments, and you can see that I did this in a lot of places. And that's actually like a good thing. So we got rid of like some stuff which we were carrying around, which hasn't been that great, but we got this fixed. So that's some PROC stuff. We fixed PROC bugs. Fix PROC driver pulse pattern. That's this one. I think they had some weird behavior in the firmware there. So a new option, max hold duration for coils to prevent burning your coils. Burning your coils by accident. So that's also new. And update dependencies. Yeah, okay. New dependencies drop. Oh, we even dropped 3.5. Added Python 3.8 support. That's actually like a great thing. Default in Ubuntu 20.04. Because before you would have to install a Python 3.7 in Ubuntu, and that hasn't been that great. And like there's been like some improvements for that in a lot of ways. Digital score reels to make, okay, reformer, that doesn't matter. Oh, what's this? That looks good. Oh, yeah, that's also something. That's something which probably almost nobody knows. So we added something where you could generate like an image of your wire harness out of your configuration for certain platforms. I think it currently only works for fast, because that's like the only the only platform where it knows how the notebooks look. But theoretically it could be added for all kinds of hardware, so that you could auto-generate like an image of your wire harness for your manual. And so that has been the idea. And I mean, it's pretty cool, but there's like some engineering to do to make it really, really great. So initial support for auto generating wire harnesses. Sure. Auto generating like that. So that's also cool. Like that's this pull request here. I think they're also not sure if there are pictures here. Unfortunately not. But that's only tidying up some install instructions. But I think he also wrote that. Somewhere. And maybe we did this earlier. Not sure. Yeah, and one thing I did is like made a lot of dependencies optional. And that's also something which we need to change in the install instructions on the new release. Because otherwise you will run into issues when installing it. And that some people already did. And that's not so good. So we need to change that in installing. So that's in general very simple. But we probably have to change it in like a lot of places. Because now you have to do it like this. You have to put this all here, and that will then install like all dependencies. And now you probably have to add this in a lot of places, I guess. So that's like an open like feature request in Python, which allows you to like define default dependencies, but currently it's not there, and therefore we. Yeah, like by default, it installs almost none of them. And then I just defined a target, which is called all, where you get like all dependencies. And here's actually a typo. Uninstall, like that. Maybe we should get that right. And now, yeah, I will fix those up, I guess. Pip. Okay, whoa, that's old. Whoa. That's really, really old here. Maybe you should get the dev installer. Not like the old one, because that's not so great. And now you should. Why? It's already done in the installer, so you don't need this. You probably will have it like this. And then it should install. Let's see. See what we got here. The problem is that we got like quite a few places where we do stuff. That's also a way to do it. you can check it. Like that's I can show you what it is actually. So here in setup pi, we got like extra. So we got like the minimal requirements. Those are those pi ruaml. .yaml, that's the YAML library we're using, PySerial for all the serial stuff. On Windows, we have to force an older version. Because I actually broke that, and nobody noticed until they released it. So, like, nobody tested it. And now, like, 0.4.0.5 is broken on Windows, and 0.4 works on Windows, but 0.5 works on any other platform. I fixed it in 0.5, but they still didn't do a release, which is, yeah. They should do a release. I would love that. And a lot of other people would love that too. And you need those few things and that's it. And then you got like extra requires for all kind of stuff. If you use the Raspberry Pi, if you want to use I2C, if you want to use Pin2 DMD, or the CLI stuff for the text UI. If you want to use OSC, it's also something which most of you won't use. If you use IRC, that's for the Twitch chat integration. For Virtual Pinball, you need something, and for the Crash Reporter, which is also new, you also need like new includes. And those are like those optional things, and all is just the sum of all of those. And yeah, those are like a few more libraries, which, yeah, you do not usually need, right? You could also run only CLI, then you get only the text UI stuff. And for that, you would then use CLI in brackets. That would also work. But yeah, I guess we will simply install everything for by default for most people. That's the best thing to do, I would say. Let's see what we got here. Installer, awesome. That's good. And now we will like look into Windows and Mac. So Mac, what do we propose? Do we propose to do anything with pip? Yes. Yeah. All like that. And now and all you should get 055. Nah, then you will get 0656. Install like this. Yeah, probably have to catch this in a few more places. Like this. Whoa. We did duplicate this quite a few times. Maybe we should like have an include just for the install instructions. And then not copy it all the time. Okay. And now that's only Windows. And we can update this to 3.8 now. Yeah, that's something we typically like update all the time. Install Python 05. Or 08. Maybe we do not want like more repeat the version more times. Let's just remove it for now. Okay, we dropped 3.5, yeah, so 3.6, 3.7, 3.8. Those are the working versions you want. Pip, let's see what we do here. Setup tool, list, awesome. If you have multiple, yep. Does it? No. I mean, newer versions are slightly faster, and that matters on embedded, but not on your normal PC. And like everything starting from 3.6 works, right? 3.5 no longer works. So like in dev, we dropped support for it, and anything newer than 3.5 newer than 3.5 will work. So you can decide what you want to run. If you install it from scratch, just grab the newest version of Python. But besides that, that should just work. So we tested on all those versions, even for Windows. And I'm not sure if we tested all on Mac, but like at least the latest version. You run into the issue with... Okay, but which version did you have before? Did you have like 3.5 maybe? Then, okay. So that should cover it all now. Hopefully, we will probably find some more places later. So, but this one is like an important thing to add, and that's why I will do this first. MPF docs. Okay. Update install instructions for dev. Okay, but I mean 3.6 should work. At least it should. Maybe in some places. Not sure. For 3.5, yeah, I mean, I think we dropped 3.5 now because it caused a lot of issues where we had to like do stuff for backward compatibility. And I think the upstream also, most of our libraries already had dropped like support for 3.5. So it has been time for us to do this as well. So, okay, maybe let's go over this a little bit and we will find this. Okay, so we did some test stuff. Oh no, that's good. And let's see. Create task that wasn't supported in 3.6. Okay, maybe we missed it somewhere, then we should fix it. If you got like an error, send it to me or in the forum or somewhere, and I will have a look. But I guess the 3.6 is still working. But if not, then we should probably fix it, I guess. I mean, it would be a good idea, I guess. So what did we do here? So, oh yeah, we fixed the bug on initial negative count. Initial, you know, a fix bug where initial count of play fields has been wrong. And that has been like a bad bug. So we had one where this actually broke. Basically, when you had balls on your play field when the machine was starting up, that has been like an annoying bug. I had it a few times myself, and that hasn't been a lot of fun. Yeah, so we had some new features. Yeah, it's the feature that, let's call it tilt improvements. So basically, when the game tilts, we would continue counting tilts even if the machine was already tilted, and that has been like bad. It caused some issues for some use cases. Okay, yeah, and we did more tests for that, and that's like the initial wiring stuff for fast. Let's see. Unfortunately, I don't have any example images for that. That'd be cool. Vector dependencies. What do we have here? Let's see. Oh, that tilt. Ah, that's the tilt stuff. Yeah, that even has tests. That's great. Yeah, that's more like the optional stuff. Let's see. Yeah, like a lot of virtual pinball stuff. New feature, initial P-cone support. That's the hardware which I wanted to show yesterday, but we still like are debugging some stuff there. And yeah, I will show it maybe on Wednesday, maybe next week. We will see. I really want this to work really well, and there are some cases where MPF and the firmware disagree, and that's not so cool. And yeah, I would call this like beta support at the moment, and there will be some improvements soon. And yeah, that's something for a future stream, I guess, not for today. Yeah, what that's like improved validation. It's like very generic. I mean, we have to keep this short. Oh, yeah, bug fixes. Ball lock fixes. When lock has been full. When physical lock, yeah. Physical lock has been full. So there we had some issues. New config is persist frame on images. That's also new. expecting. Oh, yeah, we had like a high score bug actually, which nobody noticed before. That has been an interesting one. High score mode fix. So actually the high score would only work on the first, like, on the first time you get a high score. Afterwards it wouldn't work. But actually, like, this is something Haggis found during testing. Nobody really noticed. That's yeah, that's like interesting in my opinion. Yeah. And we got like more service mode features. Let's just summarize this with that, because like we did like add a lot of stuff in service mode. And yeah, Picone. Yeah, that's the auditor stuff, and we did more Open Pinball project. Oh yeah, okay. Open Pinball project 2.1 firmware for Cobra Pin. That's mostly for Cobra Pin. But I mean, you can also, you will probably also run that on your own boards, but yeah, that's what's used on Cobra Pin. And we did like a lot of improvements in OPP also, service mode. Oh yeah, and I tested all that stuff and now it's probably even working. Tests which have been basically missing. So I thought there would be bugs, but there actually haven't been bugs yet. But like, if you just wait long enough at some point, there will be a bug. So I went like testing a lot of stuff here. Okay, a new feature, state machines in non-game modes. Before they would only work in the game modes. Okay, so that's a dev feature. I didn't know that. Okay, EOS repulse in software. Also a very, very practical feature if you want to build like a production machine. That's I guess that's like a very useful feature. Allow using EOS in fast. Okay. Better EOS support in fast and PP3 rock. So we added some improvements there. Ah, yeah. Ball search only starts at boot when there is at least one ball. Like similar to stern behavior, which is very useful. DMD visual pinball. That's a visual pinball. So what's that? Oh yeah, cool. So Anthony updated like, or improved show player and manual advance. Okay. Allow updating speed of shows. Speed and manual advance shows. That's cool. Those are like the small things which make it better over time. So what do we have here? More service menu stuff. Non-fake game test case. Boop. Lock known balls and ball controller and dumping. Okay. What else did I do? Make this optional. Yeah, that's also service mode. Like volume stuff is also service mode. Fixed error related to show pools. Oh, nice. Power management or enable on coils. So we run so what we do is we make sure that we do not like pull multiple coils at once in your machine. If possible, we try to sequentialize this to not draw too much power from your power supply. And this is like a useful feature in my opinion, because like it enables you to run like smaller power supplies and have more consistent like power on your coils. And that's like, we also did this for enable, because if you enable the coil, usually you will pulse it once and then PWM it. And this initial pulse also needs like sufficient power, otherwise the coil won't come up in the beginning and then PWM won't work. And so we added this as well, because some people had, I think they enabled drop targets to keep them up, and that wouldn't happen if they enabled like three drop targets at once. They wouldn't come up at all, and this kind of like fixed it. And yeah, that's useful in a lot of places, like the small things under the hood which make it better. Oh yes, right, I did like production bundles for a config in production machines so that you can like bundle your config once and then skip like a lot of verification stuff in your production machine. Also like a lot less IO, so I did like improvements here to have less IO in general, and we refactored a lot of stuff here to make your machine start up much faster, especially if you're running like a production machine. Okay, new feature, RGB segment displays, and new hardware fast segment displays. Let's put new hardware for the P-cone. Yeah, it's good. And segment display emulator. That's like a great thing which Quinn did. It's really, really great. I love it. Like a lot more service mode stuff. So that's the segment display stuff. That stuff which we broke in dev and fixed it hopefully before release. So, and hopefully we fixed it before the release. And now what do we have? Emulator. Hardware benchmark. New command. PF hardware benchmark. So the next thing will be like MPF hardware verify, I think, to make sure that hardware behaves the way MPF wants it to behave. So like for people implementing new hardware, that they like got like a way to test if the hardware interface works the way it should work, right? Because like it's sometimes hard for people to know what MPF basically expects from them. And we can do better there. So what's this? What is this? Confused now. What is this? Okay, it's an interesting merge, which I don't get, to be honest. Why is this here? My birthday also. timeout feature for logic blocks. New config option. For all logic blocks, counters, are they called sequences? Accruals, and what else do we have? And how are they called? Logic blocks, let's see. Sequences, yeah, sequence, okay. And state machines are different. Sequences, like that. Credit audits, no. This one. Several small bug fixes. But the diff is super weird. Super broken. I don't know. And it's... That's weird. I don't know why this is here, to be honest. But, we were just... probably... okay. It's just this comment, which is broken. So that's not what actually has been merged. Okay, that's all the segment displays. Okay. And we got animations for segment displays. Kind of like that. So that's also like a great feature from Quinn. So that's super great, in my opinion. Servo stuff. Okay, let's just put improved server support. So when I did this stream on servo, I went over all servo controllers and fixed like a lot of small things, basically to stop servos properly at the end and also disable the servos at runtime and so on. So I added those to all the controllers. Oh yeah, we fixed even a bug. Fixed bug on ball tracking during eject with Plunger. So like in certain settings there have been like race conditions. So basically like thanks to Haggis, they did like a lot of like testing on their machine and they found some issues in some cases and we fixed those. So this one. So fixed crash on multiple returning balls. So MPF would get confused if it ejected a ball and then during a failed eject got more balls than it had before. So that like there were some crazy race conditions which were found there, and that's like great stuff in my opinion. Do not crash if there's no game. Okay, yeah. Fix crash in bonus mode. So some of those are like theoretical crashes, which are tricky to do like in a real machine. And they were found with the father, but like a lot of those are like real life stuff. And what's this? So Quinn did sound player. Okay. Add block in sound player. Hey, welcome, Crayon. Those actually what the thing is that the comment automatically links somewhere. So if you click on this one, that's basically the pull request in this repository, but it has been one, and it has been the first pull request in MPF. But that has been like a merged pull request, which we merged from like another repository. And so this link is then just incorrect in GitHub. Like this is the right commit, but it's not like the right link. So that's why I got confused, I think. Yeah, welcome. So yeah, hope you all had like a great weekend so far. Had some fun building pinball. So that's something. I mean, GitHub is great for this kind of stuff, right? But sometimes it's still not perfect. So there's something which could be improved. Fix crashes in service mode. There have been a few. That's also like server improvements. Yeah, if you end the game during tilt, crash. Yeah, right. I mean, that's tricky, right? Like this, it's nice that they give us those links, but yeah, I mean, obviously, you would have to prefix them with some unique prefix somewhere, and that would like get tricky quickly, right? Yeah, that one is also nice. So it's a new setting. New option in servos. So then you can basically move your servo and then tell it to disable. And that's useful in case there's a ball behind it or somewhere so that it wouldn't like heat up and then break, which happened to some people. So I added this option here for, I think Coleman has had this issue. Yeah, that's right. So like wrong documentation is usually worse than no documentation. So that's totally true in my opinion. So I had cases where I relied on the documentation and then later I looked into the source code and found out, yeah, it's not quite this way, right? So for example, I had cases where documentation said it's random, but in reality it was hashing on something, so it has been kind of predictable. But yeah, I relied that it has been random, but it hashed the name, and that has been like the same name always gave me like the same random stuff. So kind of those kind of things which are really annoying because you say, yeah, documentation looks like that, why it's not working? And that's the bad thing in my opinion. Reset timer and show it one step back. Oh, okay, cool. Fix timer on step back. And what is it? And advance in shows. I remember this one. Ah, it's all pcone stuff. Support switches in Pololu tick. Was it? Yeah, and tick controller. Yeah, that's cool. That's all like refactoring fixes. Yeah, those are like the fading stuff which I did put here already. Let's see. Yeah, we're getting there. It's not far anymore. We're already in May, so it's only 2 months to go. Invert diverter. Oh, yeah. Fix ball search behavior for diverters. So that has been broken for some reason. More segment displays. Lissy stuff. Fix, yeah, like I fixed some fade issues. So like there are like a lot of improvements, usually small ones. So not so huge. I mean, a few huge things like all those segment displays, for example. But yeah, like a lot of stuff here. So all the pcone stuff. What else do we have? Subscriptions. Ooh, cool. It's like add more subscriptions and placeholders everywhere. Is this 8-segment stuff working? Of course it's working. I think so. I mean, yeah, we will release both. So I will like go over MC next, but you will see that MC doesn't have so many changes, and most of them are also here because like the config changes are in MPF, so it's quite simple. And that's like bug fixes for new stuff, all bug fixes for new stuff. New spinner device, also new. Ah, New crash reporter. So you will see that in any crash, it will ask you in the future if you want to like report the crash to me, basically. And I run like a server which like collects them. Currently it does nothing with them, but I plan to like aggregate them and have some statistics on which crashes happen how often. But it's very transparent, so it asks you if you want to send it, and you can put like a configuration option in your machine config to always send it if you want, or also to never send it and not annoy you anymore. So you can decide. That will, yeah, right. It will wake me up at night, and then I will fix the bug instantly. Yeah, that's what will happen. So that's all, like, that's the crash reporter stuff here. Cache revalidation, yeah, like we had some issues there, I think. Yeah, that got better, but it's a small thing. Alright, switch and starting game from S start. Okay, so it's a cool. This fixes volume, yeah. Crash reporter. Segment mappings, yeah. Like, more and better segment mappings. Yeah, like 8 segments is something I got. I don't know. Let's see how they are called. Segment. Let's see how that is called. It's like 8 segments, 14 segments, 16 segments. That's what we got. And I think. Yeah, that's this one. So like that's what I added, right? I added like those 8 segments. I mostly like took them from your document, and for those which weren't there, I just basically took 7 segments and modified them myself, right? So if they are not great, then please provide like pull requests or tell me which ones are not great. So those are in here, yeah, and they are called like 8 segment, like similar to 7 segment and so on. So that's that should look decent. I hope. Yeah, and like Cobra, he improved segment mappings like by a lot. Yeah, then like the doc is wrong. Maybe we need to update it once more, because like that's what we actually got here, like at least in light segment displays, those are the valid ones. So we can generate those. So they are like doc tools, and you can run like Python rebuild config reference for light segment display device. Okay. I did nothing. Add segment displays. Okay. Okay, that's unfortunately not auto-generated. Some of our docs are auto-generated, some are not. So maybe that hasn't been updated. So I try to update the stuff which is auto-generated, but sometimes it doesn't pass this way, like here, and then this cannot be auto-generated, so we have to fix this manually, I guess, or we have to like fix the format from this file. So like as usual, there are multiple ways to do stuff. I aim at like fixing all the formats of all like references, but there's also like there are few which got like an odd format. Segment display emulator. Okay, so the emulator. So where's the emulator? Yeah, right. Because it hasn't been added here. I only added it in Light Display Player, but not in the emulator. Segment Display Emulator. Yeah, okay, looks hard-coded here, so we probably have to add more ways here. So yeah, that's something we should add. I didn't know that this is different, but yeah, would be something to fix. I will add it to my list of things to do. More mappings to segment display emulator. Okay, got it on my list. One more on the list, as usual. The list only grows. But sometimes, yeah, I also like big stuff. Okay, yeah. Oh, that's it. And that's it. So one small thing is like, is this a bug fix? It's like it's better drop target event behavior. So what we would do, what we did before, was like we would repost the down events on drop targets after ball search, for example, or like also on mode restore and like on some unexpected places. And that has been fixed. Anthony like fixed or improved this behavior. So like we got some breaking changes, we got this, we do not have others, I think. And so now let's now go to MPFMC, so we can you will see that this is like there's like only dev 12, so that's a lot less, and we will probably not have many pages here, and it will be only Quinn and maybe some small fixes, but yeah, it's only it's 3 pages here. So new dev version, so here it started. That's the stuff we already had, like with the persist frame. New credentials. Yeah, that's the disabled displays. Yeah, Python support also. So we added also 3.9 support, looks like. Okay, so probably also support Python 3.9. Yeah, I think we do. I think we even support 3.9. I'm not sure how good we test it. Hi, Freezy. Yeah, I always get this wrong. You're right. It's Virtual Pinball Engine. Because it's Virtual Pinball, it has been Virtual Pinball before, right? I'm sorry. I always get this wrong. So, so that's supported, but like... Yeah, Freezy is the guy doing like the Visual Pinball Engine, which is coming along, I think, right? So it's the future of pinball emulation or pinball, yeah, emulation, right? So will there be like a real like release or something? So is Visual Pinball going to be released at some point, or is it like? What's the state there? Or is it still like in development and not ready for prime time, or what's the state? I don't know, to be honest. It's with some visual. Yeah, you're right. It's also Visual Pinball. Yeah, yeah. I always get that wrong. Okay, a lot of linting here. Yeah, so that's this stuff from Anthony. That's the segment display emulator from Quinn, and more tests. And that's mostly it. I mean, Quinn did a lot of great stuff here, but it's like all related to segment displays, because I mean there aren't any bugs in MC. Oh, there's one. fix bitmap font bugs. I think we didn't properly pass some stuff. And that's basically... Yeah, that's small things. But that's basically what it is. Freezy. I mean, yeah, I would call it Freezy. But I'm a German, so I don't know. And but he's also a German, so we probably got the same pronunciation. But maybe other people would spell it differently. Yeah, and that's the that's definitely a cool one. So we got now a changelog which we can publish, and we need like this one here. So we got step one out of our checklist, this one here, create the post. And now we will also update the changelog, which isn't release notes. So which will be like a little bit less than the previous versions, but I mean, I guess like the previous one have been like a little bit over the top in my opinion. So released will be like today on June? Yeah, right. 25th, 2021, like this. Yeah, we probably have to use those. That's the challenge with the different formats. This is RST and the other thing is Markdown, and now we have to reformat this a little bit. Otherwise it will be unhappy. Not sure if we can... Let's just replace those beginning. So minus with this one, and we're going to have a regex, so it will replace all those. Yes, that's all. Bam, now it should be good. Okay, so we got release notes and we will commit those at release notes. Bam. Okay, now we will go into the actual release process, and that's basically a little bit mechanical. So we will create branches for all of our repositories. So usually that's called like o33.x or something, and the same for o55.x. And what we will create now is like we will create a new branch based on develop. Not sure if I can actually click that. I don't think so. So what I will do is I will do this manually here. We'll check out the dev branch. I will pull the latest changes in case it's not up to date, but it's up to date. And now I will create a branch 055x. And push the branch. It will ask me to type this command. And now we got this new branch here. And I think we will do this for MPF, MPF MC, monitor examples, and the installer. Okay. We can do that. So next will be MPF MC. And yeah, I think it's also a quite quite technical community, right? So this this emulation community, there are like a lot of cool people around there in my opinion, so which basically try to drive technical stuff into perfection, because that's sometimes like a little bit tricky to get this emulation stuff working like reliably and also like performant, right? So yeah, I like those communities. So also like the PinMame community and all the emulation communities. Those are great communities, in my opinion. A lot of very talented people. Sometimes socially tricky people, but at least most of the time very friendly, and also like a lot of fun to work with. At least from what I experienced so far. I mean, yeah, the homebrew pinball community is also quite friendly. I mean, the general pinball community, you all know Pinside, I guess. It's not always very friendly, but yeah, I mean, how would you put it, right? Like, people which are great at what they are doing, but like, which you, at least most, like larger employees, but employers, like wouldn't hire because like they are tricky during like social interactions, and it's sometimes sad. So I mean, sometimes very very good people, but then you basically cannot like hire them because HR says, well, no, that won't work. So. That's sometimes sad. I mean, I had that at work, so. But I mean, yeah, that's like, that happens for a reason in large companies. And yeah, I guess it makes sense on a larger scale, but sometimes, yeah, I would like to have it like a little bit different for individual people, right? So. Create a branch O55 based on latest. Okay. Let's pull the latest. Check out B. ABB. Which branch do I need to create now? So, like the last release, right? So, I need to create. So, dev is the next release. The current release is latest, that's 054. Yeah, so we got probably, do we have? Yeah, perfect. So that could be like improved here a little bit. So now we fork the documentation. So we got like the old documentation preserved in the 54 branch. And now we go to read the docs. So that's basically the very friendly open source service, or like it's not an open source service, but it's a service which offers like to open source projects to host their documentation. And it's really a great service in my opinion. It's really, really helpful. And now I need to add a new version here. Activate a version, and that's 054. Probably needs a few seconds until it actually found my new branch. Did I push it? Yeah, I pushed it. So that often takes a while. So we will wait for that. and we will just go on. So we will do this later. Remove the redirect at, okay, so we will have to redirect, which, yeah. And now increase versions to, okay. In those branches, okay. So we could have done this instantly, but we didn't. So we got, now we got like the version here. And it has been like def. Nah, wrong. MPF version. And now we have to like put this as version 055 because like it's the release version. So commit release 055 in pf, same for mpfmc. Basically just delete the def suffix and that's basically it. Release 055. And same for the monitor, and that should, like, thanks to the magic of continuous integration, this should just work. Maybe, maybe not. I hope I only committed those changes. Release. I hope I didn't have any changes in my Git. Yeah, I should, right? I should actually do that. I just want to check if I pushed the right stuff here. Or if I just... No! Let's revert it. I did it wrong. That's what you get from not running a clean environment. that's bad. So what did I want to do? So I reverted the commit. But now I want to unstash it. But I do not want to, like... So I will do something tricky. I will revert the revert. Because I want my local changes back. Yeah, but the problem is that I do not want to, like, force push on Git on the master branch or on the release. It's a release branch, so I can do this, right? So I mean, the easiest way would be to do it like this, right? Now I got the changes back. And now I do reset head again. Now I got this change. But got some local changes. I got MPF version. Okay, now I got this change. Okay, let's do it different. So, like, I could do git revert on this commit. Okay, now I got my local changes back. And now I will just commit the correct file. So, or is this right? So what I committed, let's check it here. So committed the wrong stuff. I mean, reflog would probably work. So I didn't want to commit those files because that's not finished yet. And now I got those changes, basically, yeah, where those are removed, right? And that's also not what I want. So I will check out those two files. And now if I do reset head, that should give me my local changes back, right? Yeah. Yeah, perfect. And now I will just create a new commit. I guess that's the easiest way. It's not the nicest way, I know. And now it will complain because I have to force it. And since I did not protect the branch yet, this will work. But I know that it's not. Yeah, this will now complain. Yeah, I know. And now I did. Did I? Ah, yeah, no, I'm deaf. I'm deaf. It's the wrong commit. Yeah, right. So now this should be the correct one. Yeah. So that should be it. That should hopefully work. So let's check npf mc. Did I do it right or didn't I? I did it right. I checked the monitor already. So we made this part. And that should basically already like now build the artifacts and push them because CI does its magic. Let's see. For some reasons, read the docs did not like get our new version. We had this before, but I think this automatically fixed later on. So now we want to like this one prefix is basically the new version goes to latest like that. Yeah, that will appear soon. Soonish, I hope. We had this in the past, but that will work. So increase versions in the dev branch. Yeah, that makes sense. Let's start with npf git checkout dev. And here I do not want to do crazy stuff like I just did. Hopefully we don't have to. So we increase the version, go to dev 1. Yeah, I need to commit this stuff to a new branch. New dev version 056. Okay. So we got a new dev version. Git checkout dev. I do not have to pull right. MC version. So that's how we do that. So here we got like at least we need 56. And as you can probably see, our releases are very, very simple. So our release process in general is very simple. New dev version. Let me check the Git editor, right? So I can do git config core editor. What do I put there? Vim? Probably, right? Yeah, we will see in a minute. Let's Vim. Let's put -- global, right? And then I will have it everywhere, hopefully. If you have monitor. We will see here. Oh no, I'm wrong. Git checkout dev. Yeah, it didn't change much, to be honest. So we need this version. I didn't change with just start with 0. Git status. Didn't work. And new. Let's try that again. So git core editor vim. That works better, but global didn't work. But maybe I have to put global in the front. New dev version 056. Git config help. Rory Global. Like this. Yeah, right. We'll see. Okay. And now we got like something tricky to do. We have to update the latest branch. So, and because so, and the tricky thing is that we have to now put dev to latest. Right? Is it right? Or is it? Yeah, dev goes to latest, and that's like a little bit tricky. So for that, we have to change. Like in general, we will also run like branch protection rules here. So we will like add a rule and we will protect 055.x so that you cannot do the stuff which I just did to basically prevent force pushes. Okay, yeah, like you can use the editor in your bash his bash RC, right? So that's also like useful, I think. But yeah, we will see in a minute if that works. So okay, we add this one. Let me just protect the branches so that I don't do dumb stuff. Here we do have 55, yeah. I think that's very useful. So it probably has prevented me from doing a lot of bad things. You can remove it again, but it's like an additional step and you are hopefully thinking before you do something dumb about it twice. And that's why we have branch protection rules. And those basically then prevent, do we have to save it? No, I think it's already done. Yeah, and that's it. And now like to the dangerous stuff, and that's like we have to change the latest branch based on dev. So we have to remove the branch protection rule. So that's what we do. Remove branch protection, set current branch. Okay, and basically what we do is we go to dev. And now we go in conf.py, we update current branch to 055x. Yeah. In Travis, we got dev. And we update dev to 055x. Because otherwise, we won't build it with the correct version. Even the installer goes in the correct version here. Yeah, one thing which I forgot. I need to update the MPF installer. Which branch are we? Yeah. So this one is very important here. Otherwise, a lot of people will complain. So we do it like this. We push that one to 55, and we also just like cherry pick that to dev. You could also merge it, but that's easier this way. Otherwise this will run into issues in a lot of places. Maybe we should like have an install minimal or something in the future which we can then use like in our CI and so that it just installs faster because it doesn't have to install all the dependencies. So that might be something. Yeah, I will write this down because that might be useful. Okay, got that. Yeah, and now we got the branch in Travis. Let's see if they're more dev. No. Let's see. Does anybody know how you escape this properly? Like this? Doesn't work, right? This works. Yeah, I think we already did this in general everywhere, so... Yeah, we no longer have that. Update Linux installer reference instead of dev. Okay, install. Linux install dev. O.55x. Yeah, it's good. Let's just search for this. Because there are probably more places for it. Yeah, that's what I imagined. 455x. F055X. So we got that one, and the last one is already patched, right? Awesome. Okay, and now we commit the changes. Update docs for 055. Are we on dev? No. Git. So now we do like the dangerous stuff. Don't do this at home. So we delete the latest branch. We create a new latest branch based on dev. And now we change version on latest. And now we need to push this one, and we need to push it hard. And that's like the dangerous stuff, but we already created like the 055 branch. Let's verify this one last time. At the 54 branch, right? Based on latest. Let's see if the commits look correct. Yes, that's right. Yeah, that's like what we got on latest. Yeah, that's correct. So we got this, and we got dev, which is newer. That's good. We push this, it will complain, and we will do false. I know what I'm doing, as you saw earlier. So hopefully I didn't break it too hard, but now it should build latest. Now it found our new branch, and it also already activated the version. So now there should be a new version in like the docs, and we need to re-add branch protection, very important, and we will do that. Latest, bam. Okay. Da-da-da. Update dev branch and MPF docs. Okay, to next release. That's fair. Conf.py. So we will just add this variable here. Branch, yeah, that's correct. Update next dev version. Okay, like that. Okay, I protected those branches already. Maybe not on the docks. Maybe I did. I didn't. That's at 54. Let's also protect the installer. And then we are already good to go. Then we check how much of our stuff actually did build. I have no idea, to be honest. What did I call it? Yeah, I did call it 55x. Yeah. Let's protect those as well. We didn't before. 54x. Bam. And we will also protect the new one. Did we protect dev? We did. That's good. And that's awesome. This one is actually wrong. We need to fix this one because it's .x. Publish release post on our forum. Okay, but we will now check PyPy. So that's basically the Python repository. I don't know. MPF. I do not want to log in. 54.6. That's not good. It should give us like a newer version. But maybe CI is still busy. Because I pushed like a lot of stuff now. And yeah, this one is like building the dev version. And here it should, yeah, I think like the Windows CI is actually pushing the versions. Yeah, and this is basically still like building. It will probably take a while until they are appearing. And so those failed because I deleted the branch. And like for the Windows CI, we only got like one concurrent worker. Probably still, yeah, it's running the, but it will start like in a minute. It's running the MC version. So let's see how it looks for the MC. Yeah, so we got a new version here. And let's check MPF monitor. Also got a new version there. It's just that we need MPF, but I don't see any reason why this shouldn't work. So we can also check now the docs. That should now say it's probably still generating, but it should give us like also not yet. Maybe. And this page is always German for some reason. Yeah, but it's still like running dev. And there should be like 54. No, not yet. But we can probably already serve it. Yeah, no. It's not yet there. That's interesting. Do I have to enable it somehow? Maybe that also takes a while. So weird. Active, hidden, no, it should be active, right? And stable is usually this version, not, yeah, right, it's right. Stable is a link to this one, yeah. But that version isn't there yet. Weird. But that will be there in a minute. So I'm certain about that. Let's see what the dev version says. It should be the 56. That will be there in a minute. Version in our forums header. Okay, let's do that. I guess I have to up. I will use another browser for that where I'm already logged in. Give me a sec. Okay, MPF. Users. And now we can somewhere you can that's they changed Google Groups, right? And every time I'm searching again where I can edit this header here. It's somewhere, it's possible. It's still possible. But yeah. They changed a lot of stuff. Okay. And we also need to push the blog post, I guess. So that's so basically we add this post committed at release blog post and we push that. It's very simple and that will give us the blog post for the release. Yeah. So we need to, yeah, so that looks good. We got this covered. We got inform post on pin side, on Slack, on delete pre-release on PyPy. Okay. Let's post on the forum, right? So let's see. Let's see. So got our block here. Yeah. Let's just, I would say we just refer to this post, right? now I need to, and now you see my beautiful German interface here. MPF 055 released. We are proud to announce that we just released 055. You can find our release announcement here. And find the change log here. Let's put it this way. In general, it is a incremental release with a lot of small improvements and a few new features. Please let us know if you run into any issues while creating. Jan and the MPF team. Because there are more people than just me. And it's better this one, right? The MPF team. Not Jan and the MPF team. That looks wrong. The MPF team. This way. We put it this way. Bam. Okay, did this. Now let's do the same for like pin side. Now you can see my posts. We want to go to Homebrew. I think we have like an MPF post. I think last time we just recycled this post, right? No, we didn't. Let's just make a new one. That's not bad, I think. Released them. What? Released 055 of the mission pinball framework. Let's copy our blog post, I would say. See if that works. Can we have a preview? Does that look good? No. Let's copy. This stuff, right? Because that doesn't look good. Let's see. Okay, let's remove this kind of stuff here. And just right here on pin side, like this, right? I don't know how this looks. Let's see how that looks. Maybe we should. Okay, that looks right. Yeah, I like it. Guess we will post that. We will just post that. No link games. Nope. Let's see what the people say or what the internet says. But as you know, on Pinside there are only friendly people. Nobody would at any time write anything unfriendly on Pinwall or offensive. They never would do that. Publish this on Slack. Yeah. I guess I will do this in a minute. Okay, so we're golden. It's live. So we're live. At least the first wheel is up. It's a 3-4 wheel even. But there will be more wheels in a minute, so there will be, it's probably still running. Yeah, it's still running. So it's now running like all the wheels. Uploading all the wheels here. And that will enable the installation for all versions. I don't know why it's actually 3-4 here. That looks wrong to me, to be honest, but yeah, it uploaded those. This Python. I don't know. Maybe I should check our builds because they should have Python 3.6. GitHub tag still on to do. Which one did I? Did I miss some tags? I don't know. So what we currently don't tag on GitHub. So we run like our versions file. That's like this. So we do versioning using this file to, and we run like a kind of those branches, right? You mean like tag the release? That would be a good thing. Yeah, that's a good idea. It's actually a really good idea. So let's go to 0.55x tag git tag 0.55 git push tags. Bam. Okay. Do I have to click it? Probably, right? Or do I? Yeah, right. So. I don't know. I probably have to click it, right? Now you have to, okay, create. You can like it. Ah, okay, I have to really click it. Okay, 055. Like this. Ah. Ah. Like this, right? Now we got this. I mean, probably doesn't help much because most people use PyPy. Why not? It's not bad. I don't know why those. Yeah, I know what this is, right? Because like we do not actually have wheels. That's like it's only like a virtual wheel because MPF doesn't contain any like compiled stuff, so it's only, I don't know why this is. Maybe we got the min version set somewhere, but yeah, that doesn't matter. It's only for like MC where you got like Pi. Yeah, that here's corrected. So we got like the wheels we got 3.6, 3.7, 3.8. That's the wheels we got, and that's what you can install basically on Windows. On Linux, you can also have 3.9, but not on Windows at the moment. So, we got all this covered. And there, I can now delete all the pre-releases if I want. That's like a lot of manual work. So you delete all those pre-releases here because they are not needed anymore. Yeah, so we sometimes do that, but it's a lot of work. You have to delete them one by one. It would be nice to have a feature to delete all pre-releases which are old, because we got like a lot of those, but it's like more like an optional stuff, forehander, pin side, Slack, PyPy. Yeah, so I will do Slack, but I am down now if all the people like if I'm showing their Slack here. So I will just, because I mean you probably know there are like 3-4 multiple Slacks around, and I will just fire those up in another browser, and I will just quickly copy and paste my message there. And we got this done. But okay, so and with that, I think we did it, because like everything is up. Maybe let's see if, I mean, this one should give us like the latest version, and it created the new dev version here. It at least tells me that it did, but sometimes that takes a while. Now we got 50. Yeah, so like we got the new version. If we just opened it, not like that, we go to the 54. No, we should go to 55. No. Latest would be. No, that's not. Yeah, I reloaded. Now it's 55. Okay. So that works. Only thing which needs to work is like this one, but I can figure that out. Maybe I didn't push it or something. Sometimes it's. Maybe it's often it's the simple things, right? But it should show this. Maybe it didn't run the dev version yet. Which commit is this? It ran based on this one. Okay. View the doc. Yeah. I want that, but okay. Weird. Okay, so maybe it took a while. So guys, hope you learned something today and enjoyed watching me with all the chaos here and making an MPF release. So at least for me, it's great. So now, my most important job as a maintainer is done. I created a release. So, and you have been part of that. So, that's great in my opinion. We got a release. It's super cool. I like it. And yeah, as some of you probably know, I will become dead very soon in a few weeks. So I wanted to get this done before I probably will be away for a few weeks and take care about my wife and my new child. And so we got the release now, and that's also something for me which I wanted to do. So makes me very happy. And next week I will Dev 56 should be available soon. Yeah, there's the first version on PyPy, so that should be available. You can install it. Yeah, thanks. So that's my new adventure. But I mean, that will only change the times when you got time for your hobbies, right? It will become more a little bit more flexible, so you will suddenly be up at 3 in the night and other times. So you cannot predict when you will have time, right? So you have to be a little bit more flexible, but that's okay, I think, right? You can arrange with a lot of stuff, so it'll be awesome, I hope. So guys, thanks for staying with me for 2 hours, really. Oh, 2 hours, okay. 2 hours, that's how long it takes to make a release and MPF. Half yearly release. So usually we do a release every 6 to 9 months or something. So expect the next one for Christmas. Probably either before Christmas or January, February. And so guys, hope you had some fun. Hope you enjoyed it. And I wish you a great evening or night, whatever, wherever you are. And have a great week next week. Have fun. Build some pinball. And until then, see you soon.